Which nearly broke my heart. A tramp lay dying in a park. I knelt beside him to hear him speak. The words he spoke, they were all so weak. He told me a story of long since past, of his sailing ship with his long grey mast, of his captain's cap with its shining braid, and the wonderful voyages that he made. Silent Annie was his great ship's name. Like a token of love, he spoke her name. She sailed round the Horn, high more than once. She could cut through the waves like a sharpened lance. Believe me, he said, his eyes filled with tears. Like a drunk on a corner trying to remember his years. He reached out his hand and I took it in mine. I believe you, I said. And he gave a sad smile. I remember the day when they towed her away. Her sides to her sore from the sea's angered spray. They said she's unfit for the sail out once more. And they towed her more inward from her own sandy shore. And as they broke, my Silent Annie, I watched with a sigh. I remembered her beauty when I was a boy. She was my one love, my life's only dream. When we sailed out together as captain and queen. It started to drizzle and I felt my hand tight. And he squeezed even harder as he ended the fight. And the crowd they had gathered and he watched with dismay. As the Mamluk's men came and they took him away. So I got to my feet and I walked through that park. The sun it was gone, but it was not yet dark. My body was wet. My clothes were not money, but my mind was aroused by his ship, Silent Annie.